This Week in Gaming, there's a brand new DLC for Call of Duty World War II.
We shine a spotlight on one of the coolest cameras ever.
Mm-hmm. There's an amazing charity that raises money by playing video games.
Woo-hoo. Then we'll hit you with the quickies.
And Alabama Boss gets us ready for the 4th in VR.
Oh, the coolest. All this and more starting right now. Call of Duty World War II got its third DLC called United Front, and it added a ton.
There are three new multiplayer maps. Stalingrad is a snow-covered factory district with war-torn buildings and an underground sewer system.
Market Garden has nothing but tight quarters, which makes it perfect for those who like to see the whites of their enemies' eyes before pulling the trigger.
Monte Cassino takes the fight to a mountaintop monastery. Careful of snipers perched on rooftop vantage points, though.
Watch out! United Front also added a new war mode map called Operation Supercharge. Set in southern Tunisia, the Allied forces' mission is to push the German and Italian army out of the region.
Do this by destroying a train bridge, build guard towers, and crushing the Nazis.
Crush them. Last in the DLC is the new zombie map called Tortured Path. Take the fight to the edge of the world as you slaughter your way through the undead horde in Spain, on a boat in the Mediterranean, and then down in Africa.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Three locations in this thriller saga.
The United Front DLC is currently only available on the PS4, but it's coming to the Xbox and PC at the end of July.
Mm-hmm. But wait, there's more. A brand new Division class has been added to the game on all systems.
That's right. It's called Cavalry, and their unique weapon is a shield.
The Cavalry can also capture domination flags faster, plant bombs faster, and build walls faster. Introducing the Dedu Max, the world's first 3D, 8K, 360-degree VR camera. Oh, and did we mention it has an AI chip embedded? This high-tech gadget is a professional-grade AI 360-degree camera. This means it can track moving objects to help take over humanity! I'm just kidding. But with 3D capabilities, it'll make people in VR feel like they're actually there. The Dedu Max can even stream 3D! And it can take 12K panoramic images. I know, this thing is a lot. Here's more on the AI chip. It allows real-time object tracking that's perfect for capturing 3D portraits and enables the camera to create real 3D VR images without a PC. It's the algorithm, real deep technical stuff, people. So, in simple terms, this is a badass camera that you have to have. This spotlight has already been fully funded on Kickstarter with over $100,000, and it's still got plenty of time to go. You can pre-order the Dedu Max on Kickstarter with the starting price at $2,100 for early birds and a September shipping date.
Haven't you always wished there was a way video games and charities could find a way to come together? Well, good news! It actually does exist. Games Done Quick is a biannual charity gaming marathon. Speedrunners, both known and unknown, volunteer their talents to complete some of the hardest and most loved video games in existence. The stream is live and goes on non-stop for an entire week, 24/7. We're talking Legend of Zelda, Star Wars Jedi Knights, Super Mario 64, Cuphead, Halo, the list goes on and on. And there's cool ways to donate too. You can bid on what side quest the speeder has to do or which story branch the speeder should take. Games Done Quick started back in 2010 and to date has raised more than $15 million for several charities. This week, they're raising money for Doctors Without Borders and have almost hit the $1 million mark. It's pretty sweet. Not only do you get to watch some of your favorite games, you get to watch them get played by mean sons of bitches who make it look way too easy. Plus, they have amazing commentators who do a great job of letting you know interesting facts about the games being played and what the speedrunners need to do. It's kind of like the Olympics, except everyone's a winner and there's no politics. And more people probably watch it. The 2018 summer event is going on right now and ends the morning of July 1st. Go watch it.
Montgomery, while they're playing games very quickly, we should talk about this week's gaming news.
Oh, in that case, it's time for the quickies! New hero for Overwatch was revealed. It's Hamid the Hamster.
Interesting. Skyrim VR got a big update. There's a tutorial, and you can now run backwards.
It was much needed, much needed. There are physical copies of Fortnite selling for hundreds of dollars.
Speaking of Fortnite, the next season's dates were announced.
Woo-hoo.
It'll start July 12th.
Sony gave us all a ray of hope that it's now thinking about crossplay.
Not doing, just thinking. But it's a baby step. It's good.
Do it.
PUBG has canceled their lawsuit against Fortnite. Shocked.
H1Z1 Battle Royale has added a new map. It's only on the PC for now, but it'll be coming to the PS4 in the future.
You can now play Mario Kart 8 with your cardboard Labo motorcycle. Boom, boom,
boom. A new time-limited mode for Sea of Thieves has you being bombarded by gun barrel skeletons.
And that's all the gaming news from this week.
But before we go, here's a sneak peek of Alabama Boss getting ready for the 4th in VR.
Woo. Damn!
Oh! Oh, say can you see?
Oh, oh yes. Oh, they're coming back.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's just like in real life, they suck. How do you shoot it? Motherfucker, look at that. Oh, yeah, there we go, blow up. I killed them all. Throw this when you take the top off. Look at that. Oh, yeah. Yeah. It's a 50, man. Oh, God, it's great. This is great. Oh, come on. Oh, you gotta really get on it. Ah! Oh. Ruining that blade. Yeah. Oh, okay.
That's our show. Thanks for watching.
Come back Monday to see the full playthrough of Alabama Boss shooting off virtual fireworks.
And let us know in the comments which games you're currently playing. For Rated Red Gaming, I'm Paxton Elrod.
And I'm Montgomery Brown.